Good morning from Venice, Italy. We're on the top of Hotel Laurum Palace, and it's so gorgeous up here. So I'm so thankful it stopped raining. It's just so weird because there's no cars here. Everything is on a boat, literally. And so there's this little private terrace up on top of our hotel that I just happened to see last night. I've learned in the last few days that you should really walk around and just look up because the ceilings are beautiful, and I'm all about the view everywhere I go. So I tried to get up here last night and the front desk was like, no, it's been raining, it's slippery, it's dangerous. I can't even do their cute Italian accent here. My shins feel like they're going to fall off, literally. I'm so sore from walking on all this different cobblestone. Okay, so I went up one more flight of steps, and here's the view from up here. It's just such a charming, different little town. I'm not quite sure what the roofs are built of. Mom, what do you think? You're doing so good with the camera, moving it slow. I'm trying to teach her, but her phone's really old. I'm like, Mom, just tell me what videos and photos you want, and I'm gonna make you a digital album. So a couple things we've learned about Italy and some differences is that there's no Starbucks here, which is fine, but no one has coffee to go. Like, no one walks around with a coffee cup here. Every place serves coffee and wine, like 24 hours, if they're open 24 hours. In the morning, it's like coffee and wine, wine or coffee, and I'm like, I wouldn't get anything done if I drank wine. I don't know, maybe the two like counteract each other. And obviously there's no cars here, everything is by water. But there's so many just different little things about it. This hotel that we're staying at was built in, Mom, did they say 1861?
Yes.
Yeah, 1861. I wish I had my content team here because I think that we would have a heyday having a content day here. We would get really lost, most likely, between the little buildings, but I could see it being a lot of fun. The other thing is that there's cranes here. Not a lot, but there's a crane there. And these roofs, to me, they look like flower pots that are just stacked upon each other. Oh, I know what else I was gonna tell you. It's illegal to swim here. Like, you can't swim in the water. And like, there is some seaweed there, but I didn't know it was illegal to swim in the water. That's the other interesting thing. Look at these steps to get up here. Little scary.
Wait a minute, hold on.
I'm sitting outside waiting on my mom because she's got to use the bathroom 30 times. She's got to put her makeup on. Maybe that's just a generational thing, but I haven't even thought about putting makeup on since I've been here. I just want to go out and walk before we start our tour. She's killing me. But so yesterday at the train station, let me tell you what happened. We got there an hour early, which is absolutely absurd. Okay, I'll play that game. The tracks change like every 15 minutes. There's like so many trains. It's like an airport. It's like just massive craziness. This girl comes up, she's like, can I help you? And she like helps us and like shows us our number and tells us track 11. And she like walks us to the ticket counter and then she's like, tip for me. I'm like, I didn't hear what she said. I'm like, excuse me? She's like, tip for me. And that's the first time anyone in Italy has said anything about tipping. Because apparently here in Italy, like, people don't tip. Like, that's just not something you do. I mean, the bellman and stuff like that. But in restaurants, like, when they run your credit card, at spas, when they run your credit card, like, there's no line for the tip. So, you know, I gave her €5 or whatever and told her thank you. So we're sitting at track 11, literally for an hour, and it's like 5 minutes to our train supposed to leave, and another train pulls up, and it's not going where we're going. So my mom's like, give me the ticket, I'm gonna go ask one of the security guards. So then she goes over and asks, and he tells her it's track 4. Well, so then we drag, haul all of our shit down to track 4. Mind you, we are the only people in that train station with two big ass bags and roll-on, like carry-ons, because we're just like carrying our stuff for 2 weeks. We get down to 4 and there's no train down there. Every second is like ticking. And so then I go to a different security guard, like, oh, that's track 9. So this is the third time we've been told a different track. Oh my God, here she comes finally. We walk up to track 9 and I see the train and it's pulling off and it leaves us. We missed the train because we were told 3 different tracks, 3 different times. So I went back to the security guard. I'm like, you know, told him what happened. And he's like, go talk to customer service. It's like, no one cares. They definitely do not have the customer service that Americans have at all. So I go in, I stand in this long line with customer service and the lady's like, you missed the train, you have to buy another ticket. I'm like, I am not paying $400 again for first class executive tickets. She's like, go talk to a supervisor. I go to the larger customer service area and I didn't know that there was like a line, they call it a queue here. Because it's like absolute madness. So I just walk up to the front and I went in and went up to this lady and I'm like, I have a problem and I need to speak to the supervisor immediately. And she's like, what's your problem? And you know, so I tell her and she's like, you're just gonna have to buy another ticket. I'm like, no, I'm not doing that. So I would like to speak to a supervisor. And she's like, ma'am, there's 30 people in front of the queue, you have to go get in line. And I'm like, no, there's another train going to Venice in 30 minutes and I need a ticket to that train. And she's like, well, you have an executive ticket, so you're gonna have to go to the lounge. And I, at this point, I'm just like, I'm like a turkey, like running around like with my head cut off. I go to the lounge. Well, the first lounge I go to is the wrong lounge. Then I find another lounge. And the lady's like, you have to go to the main customer service desk. We don't have a supervisor today. I'm like, the lady just told me to come over here. Meanwhile, the clock is ticking. So I'm like, what is your name? And she like tells me, I'm like, okay, Alicia, I'm gonna go back. If there's no supervisor there, I'm gonna tell them you told me that. So I went back over. Again, I don't care, there's a line. Like, there's no order here whatsoever. And the girl saw me coming and I guess she like, cause they all speak in a different language. They went and got a supervisor and she's like, what's the problem? And I told her and she's like, I'll just write a note on there to the conductor. Go get on the 11:35 train. Like it's no big deal. She's like, you better hurry. You're gonna miss it. And then my mom is sitting over at 9. I'm like, well, can you tell me the right platform at least? She's like, number 1. So I have to go find my mom at 9. She's leisurely sitting there reading a book. And I'm like, get up, let's go. And then we finally get on the train.
It's better to read a book than cry.
There's no reason to cry. No one's dying. It's not the end of the world. But that's not the point.
I thought that was the, for only train to Venice.
And actually, it was a very nice ride. We had an amazing waiter who wore white gloves while he was servicing us.